ஹம்பிள் ரெஸ்பெக்ட்ஃபுல் சென்ஸை தண்டவத் பண்ணுவான். லூடஸ் ஃபீட் ஆஃப் மை குரு பாத் பதுமோ நித்தலீலா பிரவிஷ்ணும் விஷ்ணு பாத் அஷ்டூத்தர சதசி ஸ்ரீமோர் பக்தி வேதாந்த் ஸ்லோகம் ஸ்ரீ மகாராஜ் அண்ட் நித்தலீலா பிரவிஷ்ணும் விஷ்ணு பாத் அஷ்டூத்தர சதசி ஸ்ரீமோர் பக்தி வேதாந்த் ஸ்லோகம் நாராயண் குருஸ்ரீ மகாராஜ். சைமல்டேனியஸ்லி ஐ ஆஃபர் மை ஹம்பிள் ரெஸ்பெக்ட்ஃபுல் தண்டவத் பண்ணுவான். லோட்டஸ் ஃபீட் ஆஃப் நித்தலீலா பிரவிஷ்ணம் விஷ்ணுபாத் அஷ்டோத்தர சதசி ஸ்ரீமத் பக்தி வேதாந்த ஸ்வாமி மகாராஜ் ஸ்ரீல குருகந்த கோஸ்வாமி மகாராஜ் பக்தி ரக்க ஸ்ரீதர் கோஸ்வாமி மகாராஜ் பக்தி பிரமோத் புரி கோஸ்வாமி மகாராஜ் அண்ட் ஆல் குரு பரம்பரா அண்ட் ஆல் வைஷ்ணவ் வைஷ்ணவீஸ் அண்ட் ரெஸ்பெக்ட். ஆக்சுவல் இன் இண்டியா ஐ அக்கார்டிங் அவர் வைதிக் ஸ்பிரிச்சுவல் கல்ச்சர் today the very super excellent auspicious day. You know, today that is called the appearance day of Srila Krishna Dvaipayan Veda Vyas. And also in our very prominent six Goswamis, among of them Sanatana Goswami Pada, who was very nearest and dearest of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He departed from this material world. So in Braj, that is called also Muru Punima, Guru Punim, or Braj language, they are using the Muru Punim. Muru means shaving the, shave the hair. Because Sanatana Goswami Pad, he was very nearest and dearest all of the Brajavasis. He made so much love and affection with the Brajavasis as like their family's member. That is called Laukik Sadbandhu. So when Sanatana Goswami Pad departed from this material world, this day, and that time all the Brajavasis, they also performed Giriraj Parikrama. And all Brajavasis, they also, what is called, shaved their head. According to Indian Vedic culture, if anybody left, if in your family's member left body, you have to shave. So for this regard of Brajavasis, they thought Sanatana Goswami Pad is our family's member. So for this regard, Brajavasis, they saved their head and the remembrance of Sanatana Goswami, they also did Giriraj Parikrama. Still, this tradition is going on. And more than 500 years before Sanatana Goswami's departure, but still this tradition is going on in Braj. If you go to in Braj, and especially in Giriraj Govardhan, millions of people are coming and doing parikrama. And so today is very super excellent auspicious day. Sanatana Goswami Pad, we remember Sanatana Goswami Pad, his life history and his contribution, and how did he preach the message of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And another thing, you also know today is called Vyasa Puja. Vyasa Puja's another name is called Guru Puja. But according our Gaudiya Vaishnava tradition, Guru Puja means, that is called the birthday of Guru. Then disciple offering his, what is called, homage. Then lotus feet of his Guru. And glorified to Guru. How did he receive mercy from his Guru and these things? And offering the flowers to the feet of Guru. That is called the Guru Puja. And actually, who is original Guru? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He manifested this subjects, who is the original Guru? And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, first he manifested the perfect Guru Puja, Vyasa Puja, in the house of Srivas Thakur, in our Vidya. These things very nicely and elaborately described in Chaitanya Bhagavatam, Vrindavan Das Thakur. Generally, Shankar Sampradaya, they also worship Guru Puja, Vyasa Puja, that is called Krishna Daivam Vedavyas. But Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada explained, Shankar Sampradaya's Guru Puja or Vyasa Puja is not perfect. Why? Shankar Sampradaya's, they accept Vyasadeva is their Guru. Because Krishna Daivan Vedavyas, he manifested all Ved, Puran, Upanishad, Srimad Bhagavatam, and the commentary of Vedanta Sutra, and these things. So, Shankara Sampradaya, they accept the Vyasadeva is their Guru. But Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada explained, this is only, that is called Hasaspada, ludicrous. Ludicrous means is what? They externally accept Vyasadeva is our Guru. But they internally, they did not accept Vyas is their Guru. Why? Because Shankaracharya, he explained, oh, Vyasadeva is, what is called, Bhranta. Bhranta means, that is called illusion. And Vyas Bhranta boli uthailo vivad. Vyas sutra parinam bad kuriyache vyakhan. Vyas sutra e Vyas Bhranta boli kuri uthailo vivad. Shankaracharya explained, oh, Vyasadeva, he has many faults. Why? Because Vyasadeva Goswami, in his Shastra, explained the Parinambad, the doctrine of manifestation. That is called Parinambad. Shankaracharya, he explained, Brahma Satta Jagat Mitha, Jiva Brahmaipa Napar. Only one absolutely truth, that is called the Brahma. There are no existence of jivas. Understand? There are no existence of jivas. Only one Brahma, ek Brahma ditya nasti. Only one Brahma without second. This is the philosophy of Brahma. Jagat mitha. Jagat mitha means whatever you are looking in this material world, this is completely false. This is the theory of Brahma. This is the theory of Shankaracharya. But Vyasadeva, he manifested Shakti Parinambad. All these energies of Brahma manifested in this material. That is called Jiva Shakti, Maya Shakti, Chit Shakti. In this way, Vyasadeva very clearly explained in his Shastra. So that means, Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada explained, I accept my Guru, but I don't follow his instruction. That means you are not perfect disciples. Very clearly, Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada explained. So Shankaracharya's Guru Puja, only that is called the externally or ludicrous. Ludicrous.
Show.
Laughing and joking. I follow, I accept my Guru, but I don't follow his
instruction.
So that means this is not the perfect disciple. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he explained, who is the perfect Guru? So in the house of Srivas Thakur, he manifested this Vyasa Puja or Guru Puja. very nicely explained in Chaitanya Bhagavat, Vrindavana Das Thakur. In the day of Vyasupuja, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very humbly asked to Nityananda, "Hey Nityananda, tomorrow will be the appearance day of Vyasadeva. So I want to worship Vyasupuja. Okay? We'll take charge." Then Nityananda Prabhu, he holds the lotus hand of Srivasa Thakur and told, "Tomorrow all we come in the house of Srivasa Thakur and we perform Vyasa Puja." Then Mahaprabhu little bit smiled. Yeah? And Mahaprabhu told, "How possible Srivasa, he will be arranged Vyasa Puja?" Then Srivasa Thakur very humble paid his obeisances to the spiritual Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, told Prabhu, "If you give mercy, then everything will be solved. Please give me chance to serve Guru and Vaishnava." Then early in the morning, next day early in the morning, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all his entourage, Nityananda and Sarup Damodar, others, all devotees, came in the house of Srivasa Thakur. According to Vedic culture, that is called Panchabhyas, different way to worshiping. Then, when coming to offering the flowers, the lotus feet of Vyas, who will first offer the flowers and lotus feet of Vyas? Who is the senior most devotee, then he first offered the Pushpanjali, flowers and lotus feet of Vyasadeva. Then Advaita Acharya and others, they recommended Nityananda Prabhu, he is the senior most devotee. Because Nityananda Prabhu, he took Diksha from Lakshmipati Tirtha. Lakshmipati Tirtha, who is the godbrother of Madhavendra Puri Pada. Nityananda Prabhu, though he took Diksha from Lakshmipati Tirtha, but he always associated with Madhavendra Puri Pada. So Madhavendra, Nityananda Prabhu always think Madhavendra Puri Pada is my Siksha Guru. And he is Diksha Guru. Lakshmipati Tirtha. Madhavendra Puri Pada, then Ishwar Puri Pada, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is our Guru Parampara is coming. So Mahaprabhu very happy, and Mahaprabhu told, "Hey Nityananda, first you offer the Pushpanjali, lotus feet of Vyasadeva." Nityananda took flowers and garland and holding. 1 minute, 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes passed, but he did not offer. Then Mahaprabhu told Nityananda, "Time is going on. Everybody is hungry. After offering flowers, Pushpanjali, everybody has to take prasad. So why you are not offering?" Then Nityananda is saying, "Hoy, hoy, hoy. Oh, going. Again, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Nityananda, "Don't delay. You have to offer your Pushpanjali, lotus feet of Vyasadeva, because today is Vyasa Puja. Krishna Devipayan, Vyasadeva." Then Nityananda took that the garland and offered to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Balasajinandana Gaur Hari Ki Jai. Why Nityananda did not offer to Vyasadeva and he offered this garland to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Because Nityananda Prabhu explained in his mood, "Krishnam Vande Jagad Guru." That means Krishna, who is the supreme personality of Godhead, Swami Bhagavan, he is called Jagad Guru. Jagad Guru means the universal Guru. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna. So Krishna is here, then why will offer to them? Then, and Krishna Vande Jagat Guru. Actually, Krishna, he is called the Impersonal Guru. Then, according in our Vedic conception, Vichar, Krishna is the origin, Guru. His manifestation, that is called Baladev Prabhu. Then, that is called Krishna's Prakash Vigraha. Baladev Prabhu is the manifestation of Krishna. Though there are no difference between Krishna and Balarama, Krishna also Bhagavat Tattva, Vishay Tattva, and Baladev Prabhu also Vishay Tattva. This is the process. But Baladev Prabhu, always he absorbed with Sevak Bhav. Sevak Bhav means?
Service.
Sevako Bhav.
The mood of
servant. So Baladev Prabhu in always thinking, I am his servant. Muitardas. Guru means he showing his life history how to serve his Ishtadev Krishna. Showing his life history how to serve his Krishna. And to manifest in this material world, all his disciples served Krishna.
The Guru is showing by his own life example how to serve his Ishtadev, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and his Guru in the line of Guru Parampara.
You understand? This is the actual real Guru, perfect Guru. He is saying, I serve my Gurudev, you have to serve Gurudev and same Parampara. That is called the Guru Parampara. This is the process. And so Nityananda Prabhu, in this way, he manifested perfect Vyasa Puja or Guru Puja. Actually, our in Gauriya conception, Nityananda Prabhu or Baladev Prabhu also is called origin Guru, Mool Guru. Because Baladev Prabhu is called origin Guru. Krishna is Bhagavan, he is called Vishay Vigraha, object of the divine love. And Gurudev, he is called Sevak Bhagavan, shelter of the divine love. So in this way, our Gauriya Vaishnava Siddhanta very nicely explained in our Shastra. Guru Parampara is coming. How to serve the Guru? We offer everything, lotus feet, divine to Radha and Krishna. That is called Guru, Guru Seva. Without servicing of Guru, you may not realize about your transcendental constitutional form. Without servicing Guru, you cannot realize your transcendental constitutional form. So in our Shastra, in ancient time, we see Gurudev very nicely explain the Arunik and what is name? Upamannu. Arunik, how did he serve his Guru? And Upamannu also completely, absolutely surrendered to the feet of Guru. Then they realize all transcendental Tattva Siddhanta. And Gurudev very clearly explained in this way. Just I briefly explain. Arunik, he was a very small boy, about 6 or 7 years old. He came in the ashram of his Gurudev, Dhammo Rishi. And he very humble asked his Gurudev, I want to know about Brahma Tattva, Bhagavat Tattva. Then his Guru told, if you want to know spiritual things, you have to follow my instruction. Then small boy Aruni, he completely surrendered Lord Sri Guru. Gurudev, what is your instruction? Then Gurudev told him, you should go and make one, what is called, dam. On the
stream
of the river, because water enter in the field, so you have to go and to make the
dam.
And that night also little bit raining and also cold. Aruni again and again try to make the dam, but very difficult because stream of water very cold, like cold. Then Aruni, he laid down on the dam. Midnight, Gurudev asked all his disciples, where is Aruni? No one replied. Then himself Guru, he came in the field and very loudly then asked, hey Aruni, where are you? That time Aruni, very soft voice, he told Gurudev, I am laying on the dam, about to die. Then Gurudev told, why are you laying here? What happened? That time he told Gurudev, you told me that you have to make the dam. But the stream of the very, what is it called?
River.
Very strong.
Water very strong. Current. So I cannot make the dam. So I lay down. Then his guru's heart melted. For my seva, Guru seva, you completely sacrifice your life. That time he gave mercy. Just blessing. I am giving blessing. All Brahma Tattva Gyan. Everything will manifest in your heart. Balo Aruni ki. So this is the one point, how Aruni, he served his Guru. Second point, Gurudev also explained Upamannu Katha. Upamannu also, he was a very small boy, about 10 or 11 years old. He came in the ashram, his Guru, and asked his Gurudev, I want to know about Brahma Tattva Gyan. Then Guru told, you serve to me. Then all Brahma Tattva Gyan will manifest in your heart. Then Upamannu very humbly asked, how can I serve to you? That time Gurudev told, I am giving one cow. When that cow gives the birth to the babies, and when the 100 cows will come, then you return back my ashram. You take this cow, one cow. And getting the cow and serve the cow. Then Upamannu, he took that the cow, coming in the, what is called, grazing field, and he served the cows. Then after a few years, many cows are coming, growing. One day, his Gurudev asked Upamannu, how are you maintaining your life? That Upamannu told Gurudev, when the cup, they drink the milk, and rest of the milk I am drinking. Then Gurudev told, no, don't do this. Maybe the cubs, they will be hungry, they will be again drink. You should not do this. Then Upamannu again, he was grazing the cow. Then after a few months, again his Gurudev asked, how did you maintain your life? That time Upamannu told, when the cubs drink the milk, some foam in the udders of the cows, just I lick. That time Gurudev told, no, no, don't do this. Gurudev did not say, how will you maintain your life? Eh? If I stay in your ashram, first I ask Gurudev, where will we stay? Which room? And which cloth? Many things we ask. But Gurudev did not say anything. But still Upamanyu is very strong. Then his Gurudev asked, hey Upamanyu, but how do you do this? How do you maintain your life? No, Gurudev, I am not drinking the milk, not for nothing. Yeah. Just taking some flowers or leaves in this way. Gurudev did not say anything, completely silent. One day Gurudev, one of his 100 cows coming, then Upamanyu, he is returned back the ashram, his food. But he was very hungry. No food, nothing. So Upamanyu, he became very hungry. Then he took some leaves, that is called poisonous leaves. In India, that is called Akandapatra. Akandapatra means one kind of very poisonous leaf. If you eat, you will be, you become blind. So Upamanyu, he took that the leaf and he became blind. Then he fell down in the ditch. Yeah. Then night time Gurudev asked others devotee, others his disciples, where is Upamanyu? They told, we don't know. Then night time his guru came and shouted, hey, where is Upamanyu? Where is Upamanyu? Upamanyu told Gurudev, now in the ditch. Well, how? Because I ate some poisonous leaf. Then Guru's heart melted. Oh, for my service, and you serve everything and completely dedicate your life, then I am getting blessing. Then all Brahma Tattva Gyan Bhakti manifested in the heart of. So, this is the teaching, moral of this story. When disciple completely, absolutely surrender lotus feet of his bona fide guru, then automatically all bhakti and everything is manifested in your heart. And giving up all kinds of duplicity, hypocrisy, then we can realize this stuff. So today is very super auspicious day of Chaturdashi. So how will we completely surrender to Guru and serve to Guru? Because Srimad Bhagavatam very clearly explained, there are many processes attained to law, but simple process, Guru Sususva Bhakta Sarva Lavanyacha. One who serves his Guru, then very easily attains to law. This is the process. Guru Seva. And there are two kinds of Guru Seva, just I explained. One is called, one is called Guru Seva, two kinds of Guru Seva. Bapu Seva, or another is called Bani Seva. Bapu Seva means physically serve to Guru, that is called Bapu Seva. And washing the cloth of Guru, and cooking for him, massaging him. And this is called the Bapu Seva. Or another is called Bani Seva. Bani Seva means realize the heart of Guru and the preaching and Guru's Bani. Guru's Bani means the message of Guru all over the world. That is called Bani Seva. So in our Gaudiya Sampradayas, giving the emphasis, emphasis in Bani Seva. So our aim and object, how to spread the message of the Guru and all over the world. Especially Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu indiscriminately distributed the highest praying and all over the world. Anarpita charingchirat korunayavatirno kalu samarpetu unnatu jolasam subhakti sriyam parihi pratasundrati kadamba sandirpita sada hidaye skandiris pratambi pratuva shachinanna. Srila Rupa Goswami Pada in Vidatta Madhava glorified about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. How did he manifest it? Then, Braja Prem, Gopi Prem, especially Manjiri Bhav, and he distributed these things. So this is our aim and object, how to preach the message of Guru and to serve his lotus feet.
Gracias.